Ladies and gentlemen, it is the fact that the tears shed on that particular day of disaster 4 years ago, not dried up yet. Still, the families of the victims and all of us are having unbearable shock. Fire of pain, fire of disappointment, fire of uncertainty and doubt is burning within our hearts day by day, more and more. We can feel the fire is burning within us. But still we can see certain silver lines among the dark clouds of the disaster. Those silver lines are the religious harmony, unity among the religious fraternities in the country and somewhere in the world. It is the positive fact that we could understand the unity among the religions. This fact was well appreciated by the Buddha. I can trace a story from Samyutta Nikaya. Once the Buddha was visited by a deity from heaven. This deity, the divine being, introduced himself, said that once upon a time he was a religious leader in the human world. Then he asked the Buddha, "Venerable sir, can I teach you a certain facts, important facts, as what believe in our religion?" Buddha humbly accepted and said, "Please, teach us. Teach me what your religious idea." Then the deity said, "Akatan dukkatan seyo paccha tapati dukkatan." Whatever good deed you do, do it well. Do it properly. Do it perfectly. Otherwise, better you leave behind it. This idea is actually nourished with the teaching of unity. Samagga hotama vivadata. Come with unity. Success is based on the unity. Though it was non-religious teaching, though that teacher was non-religious leader, Buddha humbly accepted this idea and then he taught this Dhamma to his own disciples next day. Same teaching we can find out in the Corinthians 1 to 10 in the Bible. I quote, "I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, in the name of the Lord, that all of you agree with one another and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be perfectly united in mind and thoughts." Religious unity is the base of the success. So in this manner, I do like to make an appeal to all those Buddhist leaders, all those Hindu leaders, all those Islamic leaders, and all the leaders of every Christian religious denominations to come forward, frankly and openly come forward with wholeheartedly, come forward to support the peaceful struggle wisely managed and led by Cardinal Malcolm Ranjit, Right Reverend Cardinal Malcolm Ranjit. It is our duty. If the justice is not found out here, we also should go to the International Court of Justice. That is our duty. We have to perform our duty towards all those departed relatives. And then this is the day what we have to resolve and make effort with determination in respect to all those demise. I take this opportunity on behalf of all the Buddhist communities in Sri Lanka to express our sympathy and also wish well-being to all those victims. And also we wish the ultimate bliss of divinity to all those departed relatives, friends, Sri Lankans and those citizens of foreign countries. Sabbe sattaha. Bhavantu Sukhitattha. Thank you.